And here now with answers to your email questions on coping with chronic pain are Dr. Scott Fishman, president of the American Academy of Pain Medicine, Dr. Andrew Kasdan, associate director of the Spine Institute at Beth Israel Medical Center in New York, and Dr. John Dabrowski, director of the Center for Pain Medicine in Washington, D.C. Gentlemen, thanks to all of you for being back here and talking about this. Before we get to the email questions, Dr. Fishman, let me ask you a little bit more about pain and children. How do you differentiate the usual aches and pains of a child versus some real chronic, very serious pain?
Right. Well, the American Pain Foundation estimates that 10 million children have chronic or persistent pain, so it's an important differentiation. You know, children will often tell you in many different ways that they have pain. It's based on what they say, what they do, and how they react. What they say is they often will scream and yell and call out that they have pain, but sometimes they withdraw. And it's what they don't say. How they react, they may withdraw, they may become listless. How they react may be that they hold themselves in positions that aren't normal. They limp.
So you've got to be very keen to these signs.
You watch that, and then how they actually react in their body. They may have increased heart rate, et cetera, and we want to watch those things.
All right, we've got a huge response to this entire series on pain and a lot of emails. I want to get to some of them if I can. And Dr. Kasdan, I'll put this one to you. This comes from Lynn from Port Washington, New York, who writes, "How old is too old for surgery? My mother is 82 years old and has severe chronic back pain."
Age is really not a factor. It's really the health of the patient and what sort of shape they're in. We help many, many 70 and 80-year-old patients with pain and can ease their pain, get them back to a much more functional level. But it's not their age, it's their health that really matters.
All right, here's another question. I'll give this to Dr. Dombrowski. It comes from Darlene from Los Altos, California. He says, 13 months ago, I had arthroscopic surgery on my knee, and I'm still in chronic pain. My doctor keeps telling me to be patient. What can I do now? And that's a good question. People, okay, when do I really sound the alarm that this isn't working?
Certainly. What you will see as anesthesiologists, we see this in operating rooms and afterwards because we watch people postoperatively. Obviously, 13 months after surgery, this should pretty much have been healed. One needs to start thinking about other issues that could be causing your pain. The first thing that comes to my mind are things called sympathetically maintained pain. The older term might be called reflex sympathetic dystrophy. And the newer term is called...
Well, but in English, what does that mean?
All this means is that for whatever reason, the small injury that you had in this knee scope, your body's not turning off the signal. And there are certain medications and procedures that we can do as pain physicians here to turn that signal off.
But again, you should be talking to your doctor about what a normal recovery period is, that by 6 months or 8 months or whatever it is,
I agree with
you should
that,
be
yes.
feeling a little better. All right, Dr. Fishman, this question from Nancy in Bradenton, Florida, who writes, how do you know if you're suffering from fibromyalgia?
Well, fibromyalgia is a mysterious disease. It presents with pain all over the body. In most of the muscle groups, the muscles are tender. It's usually associated with fatigue and a lot of other symptoms of physical deconditioning. So those are the signs. The doctors that typically treat it are rheumatologists and pain specialists.
All right, here's another question. I'll give this to you, Dr. Kasdan. It comes from Steve in Salt Lake, who writes, I went to the doctor last week and had an x-ray. The doctor said everything looked normal, but I feel horrible pain in my lower back. Should I get an MRI?
Well, two things. One, a lot of things are missed on a regular x-ray, and we need an MRI to pick them up. But it really depends how long the symptoms have been there. A week, 2 weeks, you can wait. Anytime longer than that, it may be wise to get an MRI at that point.
Does MRI show everything, though? I mean, will there be cases you'll do that and still you can't find the obvious cause?
There are still some things that can be missed. Little fractures can be missed on an MRI. MRIs are great at looking at nerves. They're not great at looking at the bones themselves.
All right, Dr. Dombrowski, here's a question from Susan in Miami Beach, Florida. My husband was in a boating accident 30 years ago. He suffers from severe arthritis in both legs that seems to be spreading to his hips. What can I do to help him?
Again, there have been so many things that we can do for patients nowadays. The new oral medications that have been taken, not just simple non-steroidals over the counter. You want to make sure you get a good thorough workup that it is truly arthritis, whether that's a simple picture of the knees and the hips. But also you want to make sure that this pain isn't coming from anywhere else, such as the spine. And this could be referred pain. So again, perhaps an MRI might be indicative at that time.
Well, gentlemen, you've all been a big help. As we said, a lot of folks responding to this series. Thanks very much for being here, Dr. Scott Fishman, Dr. Andrew Kasdan, and Dr. John Dombrowski. We appreciate it.
Thanks for the time.